After spending the summer exploring my home country, it was time to hit the road again. We had a long day of travel ahead of us, but I was so excited about where we were going that nothing could dampen my spirits.
I'm recording video.
Oh, it shouldn't be on.
We were heading to Namibia for a 2 week long road trip around the country, sleeping in a rooftop tent.
Hi guys, welcome to the vlog. Today is a really exciting day. I'm at the airport right now, about to go on my first flight of three. So I have over 24 hours of travel. I'm going somewhere really exciting. You'll find out more about that as the day goes on. But for now, it's time to have some tea and make the most of being at the airport. Hi everyone. So we arrived in Namibia. In case you didn't know where Namibia was, Namibia is a country in Africa found just north of South Africa on the west coast. We were here on a 14-day long road trip around the entire country, starting with Windhoek. I haven't updated you for a while. The last update I gave, we were at Heathrow Airport, about to go to Johannesburg on a very long flight. After we arrived in Johannesburg, we had a very short connection onto our final plane, which was going to take us to Windhoek. Because the connection was so small, we were like running all the way, except when we had to queue endlessly for passport control and security. After finally arriving in Windhoek, we went to pick up our car, which took a lot longer than we expected. As soon as we picked up the car, there was a torrential downpour, thunder and lightning. Our car skidded down a road uncontrollably. The brakes just wouldn't work because the road was so slippery. And then finally, on our way to our first campsite, we passed a bus which tipped over in the road. Well, it was quite traumatic. I took some footage of it. Here it is.
I think quite a bit as well. This is like insane. Like, you just never see that normally.
No.
Maybe they had braking issues and they slid off the road and hopefully people are okay.
Goodness.
So when we did arrive at the campsite, we were exhausted, and the last thing on my mind was filming.
Well, I did manage to film enough for this segment. For our first night in Namibia, we were staying at a campsite called the Trans-Kalahari Inn. The campsite was located a convenient 15-minute drive from the capital city of Windhoek. The campsite served great food and had a really friendly cat. What else could you need? Our day then ended with another thunderstorm.
We had an unexpected lie-in this morning, so we're rushing off again. And we rushed off for our activity, which was the carnivore feed at Naankuse Wildlife Sanctuary, which was amazing.
For our first full day in Namibia, we had a very exciting activity planned.
For us as well. Oh my,
what was that?
Well, I'm putting my window up. It's a dung beetle.
We were going to Naankuse Wildlife Sanctuary to take part on a carnivore feed, which involved feeding some of the sanctuary's rescued animals, including baboons, cheetahs, leopards, wild dogs, caracals, and lions.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Naankuse Wildlife Sanctuary. So I'm going to be your guide for this. So the cheetahs is not here. I have to call them to come. Okay. Cop.
There they come.
Oh!
Don't touch any fences, mind electric fence.
Incredible, isn't it?
So you have mind electric fence, there are two cheetahs in here. I'm gonna call Aisha, this is Kiki coming.
I had actually been to Naankuse before, 4 years ago in 2013. I had volunteered there for 2 weeks, and can honestly say it was one of the best experiences of my life so far.
And you can see the people. You see that? When they see people around them, they are more protectable, they are safe, there's no predator to approach them. And that's why they come.
Our guide Solomon introduced us to the baboons before we went to feed the cheetahs. The cheetahs were two sisters.
If a cheetah is hooded,
they were brought to the sanctuary as orphaned cubs and were bottle fed and hand raised. As a result, they felt safe whenever they were around humans, including when around us.
Aisha, Kiki, come here. Kiki, Aisha, don't fight. Come. Kiki. Aisha, come back.
Next to be fed were the leopards. The leopards weren't quite as excited for their food as the cheetahs had been. It took a very long time for them to appear and slowly swagger over to where we were standing at the fence.
Leopards never stay together. That's why Skiru here is dividing the clothes in half. Sakira by herself and Billy by himself. They never stay together. They only come together for feeding. When you go to the farmer, we stop one farmer.
Next up were the African wild dogs. You may never have heard of these guys before. And that's because, despite being incredibly successful predators, they are highly endangered. There's thought to be less than 500 of them left in the wild. Naturally, wild dogs have massive territories. Habitat loss as a result of humans has really affected them. From the wild dogs, we then moved on to the caracals. Caracals are relatively small, lynx-like cats.
you can recognise them by their sandy-coloured pelts and black tufty ears. Caracals are normally solitary animals, so seeing two together, there was a lot of hissing. In the wild, they often catch birds, so these cats can give an impressive leap. Final stop on our feeding tour was with the lions. Before we were allowed to get out the car, our guide Solomon had to brief us on how to behave around the lions. We were told not to try to intimidate them, as the lions could give a massive leap if they wanted to. And Solomon thought that it wouldn't be too difficult for them to jump over the fence.
More calm, but as soon as I bring the meat back and close by, then he cannot become more calm. Named Clarence.
It's worth pointing out at this point that all animals at Naankuse are rescued. They all have their own tragic stories to be told, which fortunately ended in finding a safe place at the sanctuary. It's great to see what a great job the sanctuary does of looking after these animals and promoting conservation around the country. When you are visiting the sanctuary, your money is going to a very worthy cause. I can't recommend it enough. After the sanctuary, the car took a turn for the worse and the air conditioning just wouldn't work. It was blasting hot air at us, so we called the car hire place, who asked us to bring it down immediately, got seen by a mechanic, but they couldn't do anything about the air conditioning, so they gave us a completely new car, which is a lot better actually. The braking works a lot better, so I don't think we'll be skidding down any more slopes anytime soon. So we arrived at the second campsite not too long ago, maybe a few hours ago, but I wasn't able to film anything because my battery died. Just made dinner and now it's time for bed. Hopefully I'll be able to give more regular updates from now on. I will see you tomorrow, I hope. So I'll end off the vlog here at the end of our first full day in Namibia. See you next time as our road trip continues.
What even are they?
Yeah, so I seem to have got a bit unlucky.